This is Paradise telling you to break your internet radio cherry at CertifiedSound.net.
To Certified Sound with your host DJ Certified.
And with us today is
I'm a woman of many names. Victoria Taylor, Karina Taylor, maybe.
For those of you who have watched or listened to our shows and watched our shows, you'll recognize her as Karina Taylor, but you have branched out since then.
Correct.
But
I've taken the Tracy Lord step.
The Tracy Lord step. You've been in a Kevin Smith movie?
No, but I meant science fiction wise.
Okay, so having many names and being...
No, I'm a fan of Kevin Smith.
How can you not be a fan of Kevin Smith?
I don't know. He does good stuff.
I think so. So what have you been in recently?
This latest project is Silicon Assassins. It was written by a friend of mine, Brad Linaweaver, and directed by Richard Hatch from Battlestar Galactica, who was also a part of the cast. So I ended up going from porn to being able to work with somebody like Richard Hatch.
So this is not a porntastic flick?
This is not a porntastic flick. I am in a cat suit, but it stays on, so it is not coming off.
Well, what fun is that?
I had fun.
All right. Maybe I could talk you into taking off the cat suit next time we have you in the studio.
Yes.
Okay. So when does that come out?
It is a project in the works. We will have a feature in Mondo Cult magazine here in a few months when the magazine comes out. So I'm real excited about that. Again, I'll have clothes on. So it's different.
Much to my chagrin here.
It's a direction that I wanted to go in, and everybody said that I couldn't, and I did, and I conquered, and I won.
Right so, on.
I set my mind to it, and I did it.
All right. So is there a website for Silicon Assassins or Mondo?
Yes. Look for the next issue of Mondo Cult. It will probably be out around November, December, maybe. And we will have a feature in that, you know, that discusses the project and the characters and that type of thing.
All right. So now, I do believe you have a story for us. A tales of the wild plans. Of your residency.
I have many stories. I'm a woman of many names and many, many stories.
I do believe this has to do with the offering up.
The offering up, correct. Apparently, these people here in Arkansas, where I'm from, think that they have a right as swingers, as married people, as crazy people, to harass me as being Karina Taylor in the past rather than Victoria the person, if that makes any sense. So these women, what they do is they set me up, or I come in contact with their husbands, or they approach me to date me, and that type of thing. It starts off like a relationship.
Wait, the women approach you to date you?
No,
or
the husband.
Well, you know, either way it's fine.
Girls are cute, but okay. So they send the husband, and I don't know, you know, that the wife is in the background or anything. And so it goes from me thinking I'm with somebody to the wife is making a web page or begins contacting me saying that she's donated her husband and called me a whore. So, like, I'm this whore.
Wait, hold on. Donated your husband to what?
To me, because I'm a whore. They think because I've been in Hustler magazine, et cetera, that they can send me their husbands to screw with me and say that I'm jealous of them because they would never have a whore, but they love them, even though they're fucking me. Does this make any sense at all? Because it doesn't to me.
So, a couple of questions here.
At all.
Are they paying you?
Absolutely not. Then I would be a whore.
Yeah, then you would be a whore. So I just wanted to get that one out of the way. When they fuck with you, is the penis at least good?
But wait a minute, does that change if they bring out a video camera and tape it and call it pornography? Are you still a whore? Okay, that's a different show.
No, I don't think so.
That's a different
show. I think recording E Old Rumpy Pumpy is completely okay.
Okay, so no, there has been no monetary exchange. I mean, it's like I'm in a relationship with these guys who pretend to be with me, and then they have these nasty, trampy wives that are making slanderous web pages or contacting me and attacking me, saying that I'm jealous of the wife because their husband would never love a whore like me because I did pornography. So
let me see if I got this right. The couple are swingers.
They they're swingers, crazy or something.
Okay, we'll just call them swingers, right?
Okay.
They don't tell you, but they send the husband to you. Start dating, right? And then they start bad-mouthing you behind your back. Is that the life cycle we're talking about here?
Yes.
And then, of course, it's being Arkansas, and there's like 30 people. You eventually hear about it.
Right. So this last couple, he actually produced the worst horror movie ever made called Decadent Evil that was made here. And so this circle of people involved with it think that it's cute that they've done this to me again.
All right, so here's my big question. I'm going to come back to the horror movie in
just a second. They should all be sued, to be honest. I wish there was some lawsuit that protected me from swingers. Secret swingers. They're secret swingers.
All right, but here's my question. Are these husbands at least laying the pipe well?
You know,
with their porn star fantasies, can they perform?
I do not want to give any one of these sorry, crazy bastards any credit for anything.
That's a no. No, they can't lay pipe.
No, it's not a no, but I'm going to lie and say they all have small penises.
I think there's a lot of guys that would like to think that they can lay pipe properly even if they got a small one.
No, actually... he was better in bed than he was at producing a horror film, but what is, you know...
Well, okay, so this Decadent Evil 2 thing, if it's the worst horror movie ever, I think that qualifies him as being a two-pump chump, and it's still better than the movie.
Actually, for an 80-year-old, he could go a long time.
What's that phrase? The older the buck, the harder the hole.
No, he's not really 80, but, you know, I'm just...
But he acts like he's 80, and...
Actually, he acts like he's 8, and so does the wife. She's about like 3. She's 3, and he's 8.
So you have to give him, like, passy when he comes over here? That's a different show.
Yeah.
So, is there any hope for the dating scene in Arkansas?
Well, there could be if these secret swingers would stop attacking Karina the porn star and maybe try and a single sane person approach Victoria, the person who did this and now is doing something else. Or, you know, it's like they want to shame me. And I just think that it's extremely narrow-minded, and this is their way of shaming me. And I am not ashamed. I posted Hustler magazine. Larry Flint took a bullet for freedom of speech. I am proud to have been in his magazine and his, you know, anything that he's done. He's done.
I like their idea of shame. All right. Here's how I'm going to shame her. first, my husband is going to cheat on me with her. And then, after they've been fucking for like 3 months, then I'm going to talk about her behind her back. It's brilliant, I tell you.
I know. I mean, they are on some good stuff. Let me tell you, they must be.
So, for all the Certified Sound listeners out there, if you are not fucking mental, and you have to actually date a woman and get around the fact that she is porn-tastic or previously porn-tastic.
Previously porn-tastic.
Leave a comment. Oh, and you better know how to lay pipe. These are, you know.
Are we talking about where are we laying this pipe? We need to get this straight.
I think it's vagine land, but, you know.
Okay. That's where I was headed.
You're headed towards vagine land? Okay. Women, if you're out there, if you're in the Arkansas area, and you can date this woman and not be crazy, you can leave a message.
I don't know. We might fight over tampons or something.
You can't share the tampons? All right. Leave a comment. Check us out at certifiedsound.net or on Twitter at certifiedsound. Karina, I believe you have a Twitter account also.
I do. It's Victoria Taylor 9 in the number 9, who I am in Silicon Assassin. I'm Lady Twilight, but Victoria Taylor is the screen name. So.
Lady Twilight, or Victoria Taylor as Lady Twilight.
Victoria Taylor as Lady Twilight in the
cat suit.
In the cat suit that stays on.
That she won't take off, except for Certified Sound, right?
But there is... I will say this, and I'm going to let it slip out now. There is a small lesbionic screen moment, but the clothes are on. So that'll at least satisfy.
I don't know. I think we're going to have to go flex here. All right. Now for the kinky word of the day, and that is shibari, a type of bondage originating in Japan and characterized by extremely elaborate and intricate patterns of rope, often used both to restrain the subject and to stimulate the subject by binding or compressing the breasts and or genitals. I don't know what the fuck that was.
That was a combination of genital and gerbil.
I don't want to bind a gerbil. Yeah. And that is brought to you from Zero Mag, that's xeromag.com.
This is where I get to tie all of the bad men's penises to the bed.
Yes, tie their cocks in a knot.
Yes, tie their cocks in a knot. And, yeah, just tie the women, period. Tie them with their mouth. Tie their mouth shut.
Well, you know, you have these bound cocks. No, things go places. I'm just saying. All right, this is DJ Certified and Karina Taylor signing off. And as always, keep your spunk silky.
Yes, silky.
Not chunky.
Not chunky. It's not getting swallowed if it's chunky.